Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to a couple of announcements here on Forgotten Weapons. I have had a couple of things that all came together like in the last 2 days and figured, hey, let's put them all in one video and tell you guys about a number of cool things that are all happening at once. So first off, for the holiday season, we have some new merchandise available. None of this is as cool as my book, but we've got some cool clothing designs, I think. So some of the older material, like the French 75 shirt and some of the Secret Weapons series, are all still available through the merch website, which is, by the way, in the description text below. But we have a handful of new products and designs as well. So there is a sleeveless hoodie, kind of a cool thing for some of you guys who are interested in that. We have a pair of long sleeve t-shirts. I've had a couple people asking me for those, actually, for quite some time now. We've got an olive one and we have a black one. We have a new polo shirt with just the little face logo embroidered on it, which is a little low profile. And then we also have a thermos, except it is a cartridge-shaped thermos. So the guys at BBTV who do the merchandise thought that would be a pretty cool product. And you know what? It's cool. I like it. So you can check those all out down through the description, the link in the description text. Let's see, next up, regarding my book, we've hit a little bit of a delay with the publisher, but we should have actual video of pages, if not full books, coming off the press next week. And I'm very excited to get that done and to have books actually in, like, coming off the press onto a palette to show you guys. So that's days away at this point. Cooler book news, we have we've got the next book lined up for Headstamp Publications. Max Popienko, who we have interviewed a couple times on the channel here, and who of course ran World Guns website, world.guns.ru, which is now Modern Firearms, he is celebrating the really substantial, incredible accomplishment of getting over 1 billion page views on his website. It's an awesome website. It was one of the very first ones out there providing actual good factual data on firearms from the very early days of the internet. And what he has decided to do and announce as part of his celebration in 1 billion page views is he is going to write a book. In fact, he's already started writing a book, which is tentatively titled The Story of the Russian Avtomat. We'll be publishing it through Headstamp Publications, and this is going to be the story of the development of Russian self-loading rifles, starting with the Fedorov, and perhaps even before the Fedorov, running through the Kalashnikov and all of those really cool, weird Russian semi-auto prototypes that you see just a few pictures of floating around the internet, and then all the way through the modern day and some of the really unusual, interesting stuff that the Russians are developing today. So we are very excited to have Max on board writing that book. While he is working on finishing that book, of course, the next book that we are going to be offering is Jonathan Ferguson's British Bullpup story. That is going to be the Thornycroft, primarily like the Thornycroft, the selection of World War II pattern, World War II era bullpups, the EM1, the EM2, and a bunch of other guns around that time period, and then the development of the L85 series, the SA-80 program. So that is the next book that we'll be offering, but we're really excited to have Max on board, and we're really looking forward to getting the final version of his book. And one more cool thing for you, both Forgotten Weapons and InRange TV are now viewable through RecoilTV. So if you're not aware of Recoil Magazine, they are, I think without really any argument, the best print magazine, firearms-related print magazine, in existence today. Ian Harrison has done a fantastic job of rescuing them from sort of mediocrity and dispute, and they have turned into a fantastic publication, and they have a fantastic web presence as well. So if you go to recoilweb.com, you can find all of their online content, and that includes Recoil TV, which is their self-hosted video network, video system, and InRange and Forgotten Weapons are both now channels on Recoil TV. So you can see all of the new Forgotten Weapons and InRange videos there, as well as all of the old backlog. I don't know exactly how long it'll take them to input and upload all of our old videos, but maybe give it a week or two and they'll all be there. So if you're the sort of person who does not enjoy watching this sort of thing on YouTube, and perhaps you're not into Full 30, Recoil is an extra, a very cool extra platform where you can check out all that content. So I've met Ian Harrison a couple times. He's a very cool dude. Recoil is a very cool magazine, and I'm very happy to be associated with them in this way. So I think that's everything that's going on at the moment. A lot of cool news. I'm very excited about getting my book. It's like that close now. We're almost out the door and shipping them to you guys. But it's really cool to be able to tell you guys about some other additional books that we've now got in the pipeline. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll let you back to your regularly scheduled Forgotten Weapons.